In previous lecture, we discussed the basic concept of production possibility curve, its assumptions, and its basic graph. In this video, I will be sharing with you the different shapes of PPC and different shifts in PPC. Now we can discuss the shapes of PPC. PPC has three different shapes: convex to the origin, concave to the origin, and straight line. These are three shapes of PPC. Convex to the origin, PPC shows decreasing opportunity cost, and decreasing opportunity cost means when we change our combination, we get more and we sacrifice less. And on the other hand, when it is concave to the origin, it shows increasing opportunity cost, and increasing opportunity cost means if we change the combination of using our resources, then we get less and we have to sacrifice more. And the last situation is constant opportunity cost. It happens in case of straight line. It is very rare, but sometimes it happens that our resources are equally efficient for two different goods. If we are producing hats and bags and we get as much as we sacrifice, then this situation is called constant opportunity cost. Now we can try to prove whether convex to the origin always shows decreasing opportunity cost or not. We can take a combination, initial combination, let's say it's combination A. And at combination A, for example, we are producing equal to B1, and we are also producing fans equal to F1. Now if we want to produce more fans, and then we will have to sacrifice light bulbs. If we move from point A to B, we can produce more fans, that is F2, but we will have to forego, because every decision involves trade-off, so we will have to sacrifice some units of light bulbs. Now we can produce B2 units of light bulbs. Okay, in this scenario we can see that we are producing greater quantity of fans from F1 to F2, but we are sacrificing lesser quantity of light bulbs. So when we get more fans and sacrifice lesser number of light bulbs, it is decreasing opportunity cost. Mean we are getting more, we are sacrificing less. But on the other hand, if we consider concave to the origin, it shows that we will have to sacrifice more, but we will get less. Let's say initially we are operating at point A, where we can produce cars equal to C1, and we are producing ventilators at V1. Now if we decide to produce more cars, then what happens? We can basically see this with this graph. And suppose we move from point A to B. If we want to produce more cars, we will have to move from point A to point B. And now you can see that production of cars has increased from C1 to C2, and production of ventilators has decreased from V1 to V2. So we have sacrificed a lot of ventilators and we got just a few more cars. So when we get less output of one thing and we have to sacrifice greater output of another thing, that scenario is called increasing opportunity cost. The last situation is straight line. When PPC is straight line, it shows constant or equal opportunity cost, means every time when we increase the production of hats, we will have to sacrifice same units of bags. For example, if we are already producing at point A and production of bags is B1 and production of hats is H1. If we move from point A to B, production of hats has increased from H1 to H2 and production of bags has decreased from B1 to B2. So to increase production of hats, we have to sacrifice similar kind of production of bags. This situation is called constant opportunity cost. Now moving to the shifts in PPC, production possibility curve shifts in different ways. Sometimes it completely shifts, sometimes it partially shifts, and there can be multiple shifts in production possibility curves. We can have a look on them one by one, and I have made 6 graphs and they are exactly same. And now we can shift PPC to show different situations, different scenarios. In first figure, we suppose that there is complete rightward shift in production possibility curve. So initially, figure 1 shows that we can produce OB quantity of X good and OA quantity of Y good. X good is any kind of good. It can be agricultural good and Y can be industrial good. And let's say X is hats and Y is bags. And let's say X is hats and Y is shoes, pair of shoes. So these X and Y can be any kind of two goods. For example, initially PPC is AB, which shows that we can produce OB quantity of X good and OA quantity of Y good. Let's say combination B is we can produce 100 units of X good as well as 100 units of Y good. In this situation, we suppose that there is complete rightward shift in PPC. So PPC will now look like this. It will shift from AB to A1B1, which shows that the production possibility for both goods X and Y has increased. And but I mean, now we can produce, let's say, 150 units of X good as well as 150 units of Y good. I mean, production possibility for both X and Y has increased. It happens whenever there is increase in quantity or quality of resources. For example, if we increase our natural resources, that is land, if we increase the quantity or quality of labor, that is human resource, then we can increase the quantity or quality of our machinery and technology. If it happens, then production possibility curve will completely shift to the right. Now coming to the second graph, and in second graph, we suppose that there is decrease in quantity and quality of resources. So production possibility curve will completely shift to the left from AB to A1B1, let's say A1B1. And what does this show? This shows that production possibility for both X and Y has decreased. Initially, we were producing OB quantity of X good and OA quantity of Y good. But now we can produce smaller quantities of X as well as Y good. Now we can produce only OB1 quantity of X good and OA1 quantity of Y good. So leftward shift in PPC is caused by decrease in quantity or quality of resources. For example, if resources are natural resources are depleted, they might be because of flood, they might be because of wars. And if war occurs, then many resources are depleted. And if there is any kind of natural disaster like earthquake or fire may occur in a certain area and it may destroy different factories and different other resources, and there might be a flood which may destroy the infrastructure of a country and may lead to fall in production possibilities. Okay, the third situation is rightward pivotal shift in PPC, like this. For example, if production possibility for Y remains the same but production possibility for X good only increases, then graph will shift like this. This situation happens if there is increase in quantity or quality of resources only for X good. For example, technology improves which is used to produce X good only, and if there is increase in quantity of labor force or quality of labor force which is used to produce X good, quantity of labor force increases by adding new workers into the labor force. For example, there might be positive net migration of workers from other countries coming into a certain country, then it will increase quantity of labor force there. Sometimes we cannot increase the quantity of labor force, then we can do is we can increase the quality of existing labor force, and quality of existing labor force can be improved by education and training of these workers. So if it happens, then production possibility for X good will increase from OB to, initially it was OB, now it will increase from OB to OB1. Let's say initially we were producing 100 units of X good, but now we can produce, let's say, 200 units of X good. And the next situation is pivotal shift, but towards left on x-axis, it may be like this. And what does this PPC show? This shows that initially we were producing greater quantity of X good, that was OB, but now we can produce lesser quantity of X good, that is OB1. And it may happen if natural resources are depleted, which were used to produce X good only. There might be a flood, or there might be any kind of natural disaster or war which has destroyed resources relevant to X good only. If it happens, then production of X good will definitely fall. Similarly, if there is negative net migration of workforce which was producing X good, then the quantity of labor force in the country will fall and production of X good will definitely fall. Similarly, if technology relevant to X good is obsoleted and it gets outdated, then production possibilities for X good will fall, but production possibility for Y will remain the same, because quantity and quality of resources relevant to Y good we suppose is kept constant. And this was the fourth situation. The fifth situation is pivotal shift on Y axis like this. It shows that production possibility for Y good has increased from A to A1, but production possibility for X is remaining the same. And this is the fifth situation, and it happens because of increase in quantity and quality of resources which are relevant to produce Y good only, and quantity and quality of resources relevant to X good as kept constant. We can draw another line in the same graph, and just to save the space, and it may shift from A1. Instead of shifting from A1, it may shift from A to A2 inward on y-axis. What does this show? This PPC shows that production possibility curve BA2 shows that production possibility for Y good has decreased, while production possibility for X remaining this. And why it may happen? It may happen because of decrease in quantity or quality of resources relevant to Y good only, while all factors of production or resources relevant to X good remaining the same. So the last situation, the sixth situation, is sometimes there is change in the factors which may cause increase in production for X. At the same time, they may decrease the production for Y good. So production possibility curve will shift like this. It was initially AB, now it will shift from AB to A1 B1. And what does this show? This shows that production possibility for X good has increased, but production possibility for Y good has decreased. And why it may happen? It may happen that one resource which was relevant to X good has improved or increased, and one resource which was relevant to production of Y good has decreased or depleted. Suppose we got some natural resources and we got some extra labor force, or we got some technology which is relevant to production of X good. So production possibility for X good will increase because we have more labor for X, we have more machinery and better technology for X good. So production possibility for X will increase. But at the same time, if there are some of the resources which are depleted, which were relevant to Y good, or there is negative net migration of some of the workforce which was initially producing Y good, but it has shifted to another country, now production of Y good will fall. So these are multiple shifts in production possibilities, and examiner may ask a question to any of these shifts, or you can manipulate these shifts as per your own requirement in examination. There was a discuss question in examination in past years. Examiner asked the question, discuss whether production possibility curve is more likely to shift inward or outward. In discuss question, we have to focus on three things. One is points for, the other one is points against, and then evaluation, or we call it conclusion. In this question, on first hand, we have to explain rightward shift or outward shift in PPC. Rightward shift in PPC is also known as outward shift in PPC. So this situation is sometimes known as rightward shift or outward shift in PPC. And this situation is leftward shift in PPC or inward shift in PPC. So don't confuse with this. Leftward is also known as inward and rightward is also known as outward shift. So you have to first discuss that PPC may shift rightward. You have to draw this graph, first graph, and you have to then explain the reasons why it shifts to the right. And on the other hand, you will have to write on the other hand before explaining the second scenario. And in the second scenario, you can write that on the other hand, it may shift inward or it may shift leftward. And you have to draw this graph, second graph, and you have to explain reasons. What are the reasons which may cause shift in PPC to the left or inward? And at the end, you have to give evaluation or conclusion. And in evaluation or conclusion, you have to give a precise summary of your overall discussion, and you may conclude that PPC may shift outward or inward depending upon the change in different factors. Like there might be improvement in technology. If technology is improving, PPC may shift rightward. And if technology is basically obsoleted or it gets outdated, then PPC may shift inward. And you can explain all the other factors as well, like labor, improvement in labor, or positive net migration, negative net migration, natural disasters, or many other factors.